From VOA Learning English, this is the Economics Report. Luis Lopez Ramirez is a 30-year-old Honduran immigrant living in Washington, D.C. He has worked up to 16 hours a day at two jobs. He saves his money and rents a small room. He sends money back to Honduras to pay for the education of his two sons, whom he calls every week. The money he sends home also paid for the purchase of a small house in Santa Barbara, Honduras. Lopez Ramirez says he will return there someday and start a business. He left Honduras because the economy is terrible and wages are very low. The money he sends back to Honduras is an example of remittances. Remittances help build the economies of poor countries, and they lessen the burden on government aid programs. Experts say that remittances, or diaspora finance, can fuel growth and create jobs in the developing world. That money has a huge impact on global economics. The diaspora provides 16 times more money than official U.S. development assistance. That is $581 billion in remittances around the world every year. The United States Agency for International Development says that if the global diaspora were its own country, it would be the world's fourth largest nation. There are about 230 million people who live outside their native countries. Remittances have reduced poverty in countries like Ghana, Bangladesh, and Nepal. They are a major source of funding in many African countries, according to the International Monetary Fund. African migrants send at least $40 billion in remittances to African nations every year. For VOA Learning English, I'm Jonathan Evans.